If you're just joining us, we are at the first memorial service in Malacañang for Local Government Secretary Jesse Robredo. We've heard from his head executive assistant, attorney Nina Rances, also Pampanga Mayor Oscar Rodriguez, the president of the League of Cities, and Oriental Mindoro Governor Alfonso Boy Omali, who is the president of the Union of Local Authorities of the Philippines. That is followed by a video presentation from the DILG. And we're now listening to a choir perform before three more speakers speak at this memorial service from the DILG, or led by the DILG. San Fernando, Pampanga Mayor Oscar Rodriguez said that Secretary Robredo was a living example for local government officials who wanted change. He taught them, Oscar Rodriguez said, Secretary Robredo taught them that you do not need a budget to change the face of Naga.
Owing to the reforms and innovations he instituted in office, and of course his charisma, he was popular not only in the local setting, but also in the international development community. SecJes is without doubt world class. In DILG, he once again championed the plight of decentralization and local governance through the Philippine Development Forum as co-convener together with the World Bank. Friends, may we present to you the message of the World Bank to be delivered by Ms. Chiyo Kanda, Acting Director for the Philippines, the World Bank, and co-convener of the Working Group on Decentralization and Local Governance of the Philippine Development Forum.
Good afternoon. As co-chair of the Philippines Development Forum and co-convener of the Working Group for Decentralization and Local Government, we would like to express our deepest sympathies to the family, Atty. Leni and the three children, and other relatives and friends of Secretary Jesse Robredo. Also, our sincere condolences to the government of the Philippines and to the millions of Filipinos who have been inspired by the life of a great public servant, Secretary Jesse Robredo. The World Bank, together with many partners in development, salute you, Secretary Robredo, or Jesse, as you would always want us to call you. The development community has a long history of partnership in supporting decentralization and local government reforms in the Philippines. Yet, your appointment as head of the Department of Interior and Local Government marked an important shift in the focus and the commitment of the government to reforms. At the beginning of your term, you chaired a meeting with the Working Group on Decentralization and Local Government, and how delighted we were to hear the principles of your reform agenda, which you then outlined as empowered and accountable local government units, transparent and effective local governance, and engaged citizenry. You quickly put this agenda into action. The full disclosure policy, the seal of good housekeeping, and the performance challenge fund were just a few of the innovative reforms that you successfully implemented in your two short years as the leader of DILG. But your greatest legacy, perhaps, even from the time you were mayor of Naga City, was your unwavering belief in the genuine participation of the people. and you created the space and mechanisms for civil society to be meaningfully involved in local governments. Last week, just 2 days before the tragic accident, I had the honor to be with him during the launch of a knowledge partnership in monitoring local public services at the De La Salle University. In your keynote speech, he said, good local governance can be the conclusion of our unfinished revolution. This revolution can also be anchored on people like you, who serve rather than criticize, collaborate rather than divide, build up rather than tear down, people who engage to understand. I can never deliver like Secretary Robredo. He was such a good communicator. But these words are indeed the words of wisdom which should guide us henceforth in completing the reforms that you initiated. Your passing, Secretary Jesse, represents a tremendous personal loss for many of us in the development community who have known and worked with you, even dating back to your Naga City days. We have been inspired by your commitment to excellence and refusal to accept mediocrity. You advocated not only for straight and open governance, but smart governance as well. We were humbled by your personal integrity, simplicity, and kindness. Many people are asking, how will all the reforms you initiated be sustained? Perhaps we can get the answer from you when at one point you said that the people should be protecting and demanding for good governance. This may be the reason why you have always fought for an engaged citizenry, because they will be the ones to sustain and demand for good governance. As co-chair of the Philippines Development Forum, the World Bank stands committed to continue support for strengthening transparent and accountable local governments and genuine citizen participation in local governance. We trust that the new leadership of the department will sustain and scale up the reforms you started. But the real driving force to continue the reform, as you always reminded us, can only come from the ordinary citizens who don't succumb to the status quo. Let me end my remarks by quoting from your speech, which you gave during the 20th anniversary of the Local Government Code last year. What brings us together is far more powerful than what pulls us apart. What brings us together is the welfare of our people. The greatness of this nation, the best legacy that we can provide to our children, is the knowledge that we walked the Matuit de Madaan and turned this nation into a great one. Your legacy will continue so long as the people of the Philippines remember you. Your dream will live on so long as we all embrace your spirit in our hearts. Secretary Jesse, maraming salamat.
Aimed at ensuring transparency.